Hi, I'm Brendan, and today we're going to talk about monitoring and alerting in Kubernetes. So Kubernetes itself actually comes with a large number of metrics available to you sort of out of the box. And that's great because it means you don't have to set up monitoring for your pods for CPU or memory or network usage or disk. All of these things are automatically taken from the containers that are running on the machines, pushed into the Kubernetes metrics server. And from there, they can get pushed out to cloud-based monitoring, like Azure Monitor, or to an open source monitoring solution like Prometheus. So just by deploying your container into Kubernetes, you get access to a bunch of monitoring information that can be pretty useful for debugging what's going on. But really, for most applications, it's important to take it a step further. Now, one way you can take it a step further is by adding a service mesh. If you add a service mesh, well, then you're going to get things like HTTP latency. You're going to get error codes. And again, these can be pushed into a cloud-based monitoring solution or into Prometheus. But really, in order to actually build good monitoring for your application, you're probably also going to need to add some things in code itself. Now, in this world, Prometheus is a great solution. Prometheus is actually becoming sort of the standard way of exposing metrics to the world. And it's easy to integrate Prometheus metrics, obviously, with Prometheus itself, but also with cloud-based solutions like Azure Monitoring. Now, when you're using Prometheus, usually what you're going to do is you're going to import the Prometheus libraries, and then you're going to create a new metric. Like maybe we'll create a metric that says how long did I spend processing a particular batch job? So we'll say new metric batch. And when you do this, that's going to expose a web interface so that Prometheus can come along and scrape that web interface, get the data that's custom to your solution, push it up into the monitoring solution of your choice. So that's great. And that enables you to expose whatever arbitrary metrics make sense for your application. Once you've done that, you hopefully have all of the metrics that you need in order to do good alerting. And there's actually a really big difference between the information you push out in terms of monitoring and the information that you push out in terms of alerting. Because, of course, monitoring information is information that you take on effectively on demand. Right? So the only thing you really need to worry about with monitoring information is, do I have enough space? And with a cloud-based solution, that's not even really a problem. Whereas with alerting, you know, if you fire an alert, that wakes somebody up. That sends a page. That sends an email. And so you can't have too much alerting, or else it just generates noise. And if you generate noise, then it's very difficult for your on-calls, your DRIs, to know what they should pay attention to. So the most important thing to think about when you're thinking about alerting is we want to eliminate noise. We can't have noise. Every single alert that fires that you don't take an action on, that's a problem, and it's a problem that should be fixed. So in particular, I think that when we're thinking about alerting in Kubernetes, you want to be alerting on what you care about, which is, what's your customer experience? How is your customer experiencing your product? Usually, that's something like latency. And you're going to set some goal. You're going to set an SLO or a service level objective that says, hey, I think that at the 99th percentile, my latency should be less than 500 milliseconds. Now, if you haven't seen notation like the 99th percentile before, that's talking about a distribution. So if you have a distribution of latencies that your service provides for all of the requests, that's going to be the value that you're going to be thinking about. And the reason that's important is because while measuring the average or the 50th percentile in the middle is interesting, it can actually mask a lot of really bad problems. Because if you're OK at the average, but you're really slow, one out of every 100 times, you're still providing one customer with a really bad customer experience. And over time, effectively, the law of numbers says that every customer is going to have that bad experience. So we focus both on the average, but more importantly, on the 99th percentile in order to really understand how our service is performing at scale. So when you're identifying those alerts, think about the experience you want to deliver to your customer, and then set alerts based on that experience. And so if the 99th percentile latency coming out of your service mesh ever exceeds 500 milliseconds, that's a good opportunity to fire a page, you know, off to your, it's my best drawing of a cell phone going off. That's fire a page off to your DRI's cell phone so that they can then go into the monitoring system and figure out what's wrong. That leads to the final part of monitoring and alerting in Kubernetes, which is visualization. You need to take all of those metrics and put it into a great visualization tool. And Grafana, for example, is a really fantastic visualization tool that, again, you can use with Prometheus, you can use with Azure Monitoring. That enables you to put all of those metrics together into whatever form of monitoring makes the most sense. Maybe it's a dial or a graph. And that allows you to actually understand your data. So it's not sufficient just to monitor the data, just to alert. It's actually very important that you think about how do I put that all of those things together so that my on-calls can gain insights, and then eventually put them together into tools. So you're going to write command line tools that actually can automatically fix the problem for you, identify common causes, take action, and eventually, you know, build robotics, build agents that can call these tools for you, and you never have to actually wake up a human in order to fix your fix your application. So hopefully that gives you a perspective about how you can start with the default metrics, add your own custom metrics, add alerting based on customer experience, add visualization and tools for mitigation to really deliver a reliable application on Kubernetes.